Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about the tangent graph, or the tan graph. So, let's think about what we've already learnt. We've already talked about the sine graph and the cosine graph, and they are shown to us below. And we really need to be familiar with those and be able to draw them pretty quickly without a table of values. One thing while I've got you I'd like to point out. If I make this a bit see-through, let's have a look what happens here. And I move the cosine graph on top of the sine graph exactly like that. Can you see that the cosine graph is almost identical to the sine graph, other than it's been shifted in all directions, maybe 90 degrees to the left? That's the way you can look at it. Alternatively, you could look at it as the cosine graph has been shifted to the right to get the sine graph, but you can see that one exactly fits on top of the other one. They are just a shift of each other in a certain direction. So look, if I just move that back along here, you can see that they're identical, but they're just a shift. One's a shift of the other. Okay, just wanted to point that out. Anyway, in this particular video we are talking about the tan graph and what the tan graph is. So let's go straight on to that. Now again, back to right angle triangles, it just so happens that if you were to divide the opposite side here, not this time by the hypotenuse, but actually by the adjacent side, and if you were to work out tan of that angle, they would be the same thing. The tan function, which is that button on your calculator, if you apply the tan function to whatever angle you have in this right angle triangle, this unknown angle here, or this angle you may know about, not the right angle one, it always gives you the same answer as doing the opposite side divided by the adjacent side. So let's go and try and draw this tan graph for different values of x. We're going to start with the table. Pause the video and for x between 90 and 90, try and draw the tan graph there for us by substituting in and plotting it on the curve. And you should have got something like this. Now let me explain what I've done here. These values here, x is between 90 and negative 90, are for this part of the curve here. And the first thing to point out is this graph looks a lot different from the sine and cosine. It's not a wave graph at all. But then what happened was, and I didn't ask you to do this, but it started repeating itself here, here, and it keeps repeating itself. That this bit here you can see would have been a repeat from here, and can you see this bit here is a repeat from there? So it repeats itself all the way along, and in fact it repeats itself every 180 degrees. So look here at negative 90, if we draw a line up here and a line down here, whatever happens between negative 90 and positive 90 repeats itself between 90 and 270, and that has repeated itself between negative 270 and negative 90. It repeats itself all this is worth 180 degrees. It repeats itself within 180 degrees like that. Okay, and a couple of things to point out. This graph actually has asymptotes, a bit like the reciprocal function we dealt with earlier. It has an asymptote at x is equal to 90. If you type tan 90 in your calculator, it says undefined. It has an asymptote at x is negative 90. If you type that in your calculator, it is undefined. It has an asymptote at negative 270, and it also has an asymptote at x is equal to 270. Okay, so they're really important there. If you knew the asymptotes, you would know how the function behaves. You know it goes like this and goes up there like that. It goes through 0, 0. That's a really key point for us as well. Okay, so there you go. That is the tan graph. Let's try and use the tan graph now. Use the tan graph to solve tan x is equal to 0. Pause the video, have a think. Well, we're going to draw the line y is equal to 0 here, and we're going to have solutions here, 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 and here. So the x values that give you that, x is going to be negative 360, x is going to be negative 180, x is going to equal 0, x is going to equal positive 180, and x is going to equal 360. There you go. And let's have a go at two more. Use the graph y equals 10x to solve 10x equal 1. Pause the video, have a go. Let's draw the line y is equal to 1, and that looks like that. We look like we have solutions here, 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 and here. Now there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 squares worth 90, so each is worth 15, 90 divided by 6. 1, 2, 3, that must be 45 there. So that's 45 degrees. And we're 1, 2, 3 squares forward from 180, so 180 plus 45 is going to be 225. There's another one. Now this one here is 1, 2, 3 squares to the right of negative 180. So if we add on 45, negative 180, add on 45 is going to be negative 135. And here we 1, 2, 3 squares forward from negative 360. So add on 45, we're going to get negative 315. So our solutions are x is negative 315, x is equal to negative 135, x is equal to 45, and x is equal to 225, and we're done. Okay, one last question here. Pause the video, have a go at that. Well, let's draw the graph y is negative 1. It's along here. And so we've got the solutions here, 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 and here. Now this one, let's go for this one here. It's 1, 2, 3 squares more to the left than negative 180. So negative 180, take away another 45. X is going to equal negative 225. This one is 1, 2, 3 squares to the left of 0. So X is going to be negative 45. What about the other two? Well, here we've got 1, 2, 3 squares back from 180. So it's 180 take away 45. X is going to be 135. And this one here, we've got 1, 2, 3 squares back from 360. So 360 take away 45 is 315. And there you go. They are our solutions. And that's pretty much it for this video. That is the tan graph and using it to solve some equations. Thanks for watching.